Hello, friends. Welcome back to 7 Days to Die with your host, Rongo the Bold. So, I got the rest of the walk white on. Looking lovely. Now, all you have left to do is the roof. Oh, wait. Got one little spot. One little spot. And, of course, it's one of these. I have enough health. Okay, good. Alright, so inside, I think I'm going to go with a roof that is solid. Oh, you know what I'll... Yeah, I'll do it kind of like the ranger station. With a tiered roof. See what I mean here? You know what I mean. There's no fooling you guys. You know exactly what I'm talking about. I need to pick you up. So, whoops, no. Grab that just to make sure that we don't have any. Hold on. Is this gonna be right? Okay, so these four come out, and then they are just in like that. But we could do windows right there. In which case, these guys would be shingles. Am I right? So we need 8. We need 12 shingles. We need a few more shingles. We need 5 more shingles. And we need 8, 12 of those. I think this is going to be correct. I'm kind of building this. Not really thinking about it. I'm just kind of building. Like so. Okay. And then, if everything works out correctly, where's my corners? Okay, this side. We would have been nice, but no. Oh. Rotate one. Rotate one, and rotate one. So we'll go out one more ledge, one more wedge, and our ramps. Oh, I can do my, oh yeah, I can do these guys. I'm looking forward to that bulletproof glass. That's going to be cool for... I know someone asked the question, will light pass through for farms? And Mad Mole said he thinks it would. So that would be slick for... be a great thing to do for greenhouses, is have that bulletproof glass. Maybe I wouldn't run into the problems I've been having. Oh, come on. Why you gotta be like that? Why you gotta rotate funny, huh? Last one. Twink. And the last batch. Okay. Is that right? That's right. It'll be interesting. We'll have to get used to that new rotation menu. It's going to be a... Well, A16 is going to be such a whole new thing to get used to. Shingles. I need, like... Well, those are shingled, so I'll need shingles over there anyway. But I don't have that much wood on me, so I'll just do it like this for now. Anyway, yeah, A16 is going to have so much to get used to. All the new power, new zombies, new... backside, okay. Behaviors, new... block rotations, new painting systems. Just so much new. So much new stuff. Alright. Alright, I like that. I like it. Like that. Then we'll upgrade this and we'll be set. Should put a bed up here. Ah, dang it. There we go. I brought some tables, so we'll put tables in the center of the room. And then some tables along the windows. There's a file cabinet and stuff up here, but let's see if we can put a chair down. I need nails. Nails! Alright, well, this is good for now. It's not perfect, but I like it. It's a thing. Oh, that looks cool from down here, doesn't it? Yeah. That's the ticket. Yeah. Let's go ahead and just plant these really quickly. Okay. What else do we have that we can get rid of? Scrap those. And let's scrap those guys. All right. That does that. Nice. So what I want to do here, this rock slope is going to have to extend all the way, all the way along this building, and probably from here, like maybe like a couple blocks in, over to here. We can slope it back a little bit, but this is going to have to be basically a filled-in area. So a lot of work to go there. And I want to bring it back again level-ish about here. This whole area. I haven't forgotten the holy tree. That will come later. Oh. Still need those just sitting around. I was thinking about putting the docks in. But these guys, let's go ahead and put... We need log cabin wood. Log cabin. Yeah, probably need that many at least. And let's just scrap these. And scrap these. We can just, remaking those is no big deal. toss these guys for now. All right. Dang it. Okay, so we have porch. I'm leaving those as frames, but I don't need to take them up. Dang it. Okay, so we did say that this was big enough on the inside. It's very TARDIS-like. Bigger on the inside. Yeah, those cabins are always really tiny, and yet somehow when you get inside, they always seem so much bigger. No, don't. Okay, good. And we'll leave the door there. And I forgot to get my supply drop too. I'll get it sooner or later. Sooner or later. So I did three. Okay, let's get our windows. It was a block. So I'm looking at that one. And it's... I don't like the fact that it's off-centered. It drives me a wee bit bonkers. I could fix it now by making the house one block wider. Do I want to fix it? Do I want to fix it? What would be easier to go? And what did I do on the interior of the ceiling? Okay, just ramps upgraded. Okay. I love my little lake. Turned out really nice. And I think I'm going to continue this gravel path. What I may do is I'll fill this up a little bit more with snow. And do I have? I do. Fill this up a little bit more with snow. And then bring that gravel path up and around here and kind of bring the gravel along in front of the cabins, like here, and then up to there. Might be kind of cool. Yeah. All right. So maybe while I'm thinking about that, let me go ahead and put down a bit more of this snow. I really should go up and get my leg fixed. My beautiful, beautiful cliffside. I think it's turning out really nicely. Come on, snow. Yeah, this is definitely a huge building season. Huge, huge building. So I hope you guys have enjoyed it. Next season is not going to be as focused on building. it's going to be focused more on, I guess, experimentation. I want to try different things and try the new traps. I might do some heavy modding if things work out. I just wish that there were a couple of environment-aware things that we could tap into for mods. Oh, it's nighttime. Yeah, who cares? You know, once you're doing the day 70 horde at night, and you're just running with them, there's really no fear of a regular nighttime. Plus, you guys have seen me do the nightmare always run feral before, so it's nothing new. I try to make it exciting sometimes, but often it's just boring. Just boring. Alright, get this up. That ice is gonna have to kept down. So I'll have to come. See, I wish there was an easy way. When you're high level, it's hard to adjust snow nicely with a hammer or anything because you do so much damage that you break the block. So I can't come along and just form this because I do too much damage. So it would be nice. Maybe I could mod it. I could mod in a tool that just did like a static, you know, like 5 points of damage or something like that. And that way you could take these blocks and smash them just a little bit. Yeah, that might work as well. This is so much like actually like home right now. It's I live in Idaho, and the weather has just been outrageously cold lately. We're getting this Arctic front, basically, where the wind patterns have shifted in the old atmosphere, and we've been getting, like, you know, we had highs in the negative Fahrenheit, like a negative 3, 4, 5, and just been getting snow over and over and freezing rain. It warmed up earlier this week, and then it just immediately froze again. So we got snow melt, a little bit of snow melt, and then bam, ice. So it was just, it was horrible. It is horrible. It's not was. It is. It's so cold. So cold. Just waiting for power outages. And then we can all just die. Alright, get this done. Okay, we got 98 wood, barnwood? No. Log cabin wood now. I was kind of wasting time while those were crafting, and now I've been sucked into putting down snow. I love putting snow. I don't know, it's very peaceful. You get a pattern going. When we were building the white run, doing all the dirt movement for white run, I placed, you know, everyone on the server placed tons of dirt. And this is very similar. Good. Just a couple more. Maybe just a little snow hill over here. Like that, yeah. Like so. All right, that works. It works. Stop. Stop, Rongo. Stop it. Okay, so one last question to ourselves. Do we want to make it one block wider? We do want to make it one block wider because That is annoying me. Oh, shit. That actually scared me. I'm at the freaking goosebumps. Yeah, I had the goosebumps that you just jumped out of nowhere. Oh, that's good. I needed some more BDU bottoms. Alright, let's keep working. Keep working! Where'd they even come from? We must have had to run over the edge of the hill completely. Oh, I guess that worries me a little bit. If they get stuck at the bottom of this thing, that may cause some issues. Okay. So, let me grab. Get rid of that. Grab regular frames. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Is it 10 by 9 now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. No, it's 10 by 10. Is that? Hold on. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, what the heck happened? What the heck? Did I already add one? Because I thought I was going to fix it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I must have added one in my original layout and then forgot that I added one. Ah, what a maroon! What a maroon. Bear with me here. Bear with me. Feeling kind of stupid. I know, let me just... One more double check here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yep. Alright. I must have. How many... I do. See, I was smarter than I thought I was. Well, that's kind of a moronic thing to say. Since I was dumb enough to make the mistake in the first place. Okay, so get this on here. Get this put down. So 10 by 9. One, two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. Okay, I'm gonna need to go harvest some more wood. Yeah. So harvest more wood. We'll get this going. I might spend... Well, I'll probably spend the rest of the night putting down snow, trying to get the rest of this thing covered up. It's a lot to go yet. But I now have enough ice and snow to carry it out. Oof. That's a long way down. I think I can... Ouch. Okay, let's see a look at it again from the base. Yeah, it's a lot more... I mean, I got a lot more to go. But it's not that bad. This is all just new. Alright guys, if you enjoyed it, click that like button. Let me know what you think in the comments. Tell your friends, your family, and your grandmas. And I will see you guys back here for more 7 Days to Die action. Bye!